Let's take a look at eBay's best match then. We've looked at some of the things that are changing on eBay, but how do you actually get your products to the top of best match? There are four key elements in eBay's best match. They don't tell us what the formula is. No one really knows what the formula is, but we know there are some key areas that really make a difference. And the first of those key areas is your seller performance. Do you have good feedback? Do you have a lot of cases where the consumer goes to eBay and asks for help because you haven't resolved their problems? And importantly, are you a top-rated eBay seller? Because that makes a big difference in your position in best match. As we said earlier, it'll raise your listings 20-25% higher. Title and item specifics. It sounds obvious, but if I search for certain keywords on eBay and you haven't got them in your item title, I'm not going to find your product. So eBay recently extended the item titles from 55 characters to 80 characters. Make sure the important keywords are in your title. Item specifics, I know they are a real pain. Filling out the product attributes on eBay is a nightmare, and every seller I know complains and says the same. But the reason they're so important is, when you go and search for something on eBay, let's say you're a lady and you're going to a party and you want a black cocktail dress. When you search for that black cocktail dress, you'll get something like, I don't know, 45, 50,000 dresses come back. So you search for a black dress, and the first thing you want to do is probably put in your size. Now, I don't know what size you are, but maybe a size 14 or a size 8 or 10 or 12 or whatever. So you narrow it down by size, and those 50,000 listings shrink to about 1,000 listings. And then you say, well, I definitely want black, and that shrinks it a bit more. And then you say, well, you know what, I want knee length. So you put in a knee length or a calf length dress, and that shrinks it even more. Now, if you're a seller of black dresses, and you didn't tick the item specific to say yours was a knee length and a size 12 and a black dress, and maybe it's a satin dress or whatever material it is, as soon as I click knee length, your item is automatically excluded because you didn't specify what length dress yours was. So it's really important to fill them out. And if you go and look at how you would buy something on eBay, look at putting in a search term and then narrow it down, and that'll give you an idea of how items are narrowed down. And there are also always hundreds of items on eBay that have dress size not specified or dress length not specified. All of those not specified listings are excluded as soon as I say which particular type of product I'm looking for. Price is obviously important, and eBay currently, although they may be discontinuing it, give a little bit of a boost in search for free post. Obviously, if the average price of an iPad is £500 and you're selling one for £50, people are going to find your listing no matter how far down in search it is. But you don't have to be the cheapest to be at the top of eBay search, but price is obviously important, so keep an eye on your competitor's price and be competitive. But the most important thing for eBay search is your sales history. eBay look at products and they say the more consumers buy your product, the better your offer of price, style, product must be. And they promote it higher in search, and it's as simple as that. If you sell a lot, eBay will put you at the top of search results, so you will sell even more. How do you get to the top of search results? How do you get people buying a product? There's a whole load of things. If you've got an eBay shop, you can use Markdown Manager to have a sale. You can put best offer on your product. What I used to do is I used to put a best offer on a product. So say it was a £30 product, I'd put a best offer of £25, and I would then use my eBay shop email marketing to send an email to all of the people that subscribed to my shop and said they wanted to hear about special offers. And so I've got this great new product, it's just come into stock, its price is £30, but for this week only, special offer for eBay shop subscribers will let you buy it with a best offer of £25. What would happen is, because people thought it was a special offer, a couple of people would go and buy it for £25. It only takes a couple of sales on eBay to move your product from the bottom of page 10 of search results all the way up onto the first page. And just a couple more, the more sales you get, the higher up the page it goes. And as soon as your product starts getting to the top of search results, guess what? You can take the best offer button off. You can take your Markdown Manager sale off. You no longer need to give a discount because your product is now at the top. And because it's at the top, people see it and they buy it. The way eBay measure recent sales is with two things. First of all, how many sales have you got? And how many views in search results it's got. So if it's had one view in search results and someone bought it, that's great, that's really high. But if 1,000 people see it in search results and only one person buys it, 1,000 to 1 is a really low ratio. And eBay start thinking, well, hang on, if someone else is selling 2 out of 1,000, that must be a better deal. We'll put them above yours. So getting those sales to start with is really important. And then once your item's at the top, keeping it at the top by making sure it's an attractive offer. One of the things that can really help you with this is a multi-variation listing. The reason for it is you can offer multiple sizes or colors or whatever your product variations varies by, all on the same listing. So earlier I mentioned we're looking for a black cocktail dress, and we might be deciding to buy the black dress off this listing. This listing has sold over 5,000 dresses, but I'm willing to bet not many people have bought the bright yellow dress. I may be wrong, but I'm thinking bright yellow is probably not the most popular color. But there may be someone out there who just loves that bright yellow dress. And if they put yellow dress into eBay as a search term, this listing will come up really high in search results, not because a lot of yellow dresses have been sold, but because 5,000 dresses have been sold, and eBay think people that see the listing for this dress often buy this dress. The fact that most people buy a black one and you particularly want a yellow one, it's still a really attractive dress. So eBay pull up the yellow dress listing, which may not perform very well on its own, because a lot of maybe black, blue, and red dresses have sold. And it doesn't matter what product you're selling. It could be you're selling mobile phones with different levels of memory, or it could be cables with 1 meter cable, 2 meter cable, 5 meter cable. I've got a friend that sells personalized party invitations, and she sells them in a pack of 5, a pack of 10, a pack of 25, a pack of 50, or a pack of 100. If there may not be many people buying 500 invitations for a child's party, but if someone wants 500, because she sold lots of packs of 10 and 25, the 500's on the same listing and it's pulled up to the top of search results. So check the categories you sell in. If you can use multi-variation listings, make sure you're using them. And also, it means you can handle all of your stock on one eBay listing rather than having multiple listings.